Okay, so here's the deal. Don't do it. Stop right now. Do not put. We're gonna talk about that little fiasco here in just a minute. What I'd like to do with this video is I'm going to address and try to answer the 5 most common questions that I received in my initial DJI Mini 2 review. There was a lot of great questions. Thank you so much for the interaction. I love to see that. I love people seeing, discussing things and asking questions. But there were 5 that really came up a lot, and they have to do with the remote controller, the propellers and whether they're interchangeable, and then the battery. So we're gonna cover those questions and see if I can hopefully help you guys out. And then most importantly, there's one thing that you should not do, and a lot of people are asking, it is the most common question, so we're gonna cover that. So let's get right to it. Hey everyone, thanks for coming back. And for those of you that are here for the first time, hopefully you find some value in this channel. And if you do, click on that subscribe button. So like I said, there were 5 questions that really came up a lot in the comments of my initial DJI Mini 2 video. And so I'm gonna answer them in order of how often they were asked. So let's get right to it. First of all, the first question that I wanna answer is, does it work with the DJI Smart Controller? And as of right now, as of the launch, as of November 7th, 2020, it does not support the DJI Smart Controller. Now, there's no reason that it's not going to in the future. You know, because they went with the Mavic Air 2 controller design, it really makes sense that they're gonna be adding that in the future. And I think that it's gonna increase the sales once they do add that functionality. So I think it's coming, and I think it will come before the holidays, because that's gonna help kind of boost some sales. It's gonna make people buy the Smart Controller, and it's gonna make people buy more Mini 2s. So I think that's coming. I think we're gonna see it. The second question that I wanna answer is it compatible with the DJI goggles? And no, it is not yet compatible with the goggles, but that's another one that really makes sense that they're gonna add that functionality in the future. You see, people get really upset when a drone is released, or a lot of tech products, but people get upset when something that they really want on there is not included right away. But think about this, has DJI ever added complete functionality for anything right at launch? No, they never have. So firmware updates are gonna, it's a strategic move. Firmware updates are gonna come, and we're gonna see greater functionality, more options in the software. So I expect to see goggle support in the future as well. Now, the DJI Fly app does not support that so far. Pretty much you have to use DJI Go 4 to use the goggles, but I think that it just makes sense. It's OcuSync 2.0, why wouldn't it work? So those are both my opinions. DJI Smart Controller support and goggle support are coming very soon, and I'm thinking before the holidays. So again, just my opinion. I haven't talked to anybody. I haven't read any rumors or anything like that. To me, it's just common sense. So for those of you that were so upset it doesn't come with goggle support and it's a deal breaker, just chill. There are some people that were like, their world was flipped upside down because it didn't have goggle support. So just be patient. I really do think it's coming. So now, the third thing, the third most common question that I received, does the Mavic Mini propellers work on the Mini 2? And the answer is yes and no. So what I did is yesterday I flew the Mini 2 and I put on the Mavic Mini propellers, the older propellers. They're a little bit thinner, not quite as sturdy. So I did that and it worked, but I did notice right away that the screws were a little bit different size, but I tried it and they went in. They went into the mounts, they went into the motor mounts, and I flew the drone and it worked perfectly. And it's flying. It flew around fine. It was actually quieter than I thought. I thought it was gonna be louder. I thought the Mini 2 was gonna be louder with those older props on there, but it was still pretty quiet. And so then what I wanted to do, the other question that a lot of people were asking, can you use the Mini 2 propellers on the Mavic Mini? And will that make it quieter? And will that make any changes? And so what I did is I took off the Mini 2 propellers off of the, I took the Mavic Mini, boy, it's hard to keep all this straight. I took the Mavic Mini props off of the Mini 2. And then I was gonna put the Mini 2 props on the Mavic Mini. And what happened was they don't fit. The screws are different sized and they're threaded differently. And so then I realized right away it's not gonna work. Plus those screws don't go in all the way. They don't even reach out of the bottom of the propeller. And so I thought, okay, well, I'm gonna put my Mini 2 props back on the Mini 2. And when I did that, the screws would not go in. I think what happened is because the thread is different and those screws are a different size from the Mavic Mini props, I think I retooled my Mini 2 prop mounts. And so when I put them back on, they went in really hard. I did get them in, but there was one that I could not get. It was almost like it was stripped, and that really concerned me, but I did get it in, and I flew it a little bit, and it had kind of an odd noise. Okay, I'm just gonna fly around a little bit. It does sound different. One of those motors sounds different. So it had like a low pitch hum to it, and it was just, it was different. And so you could hear it, and it was in the one prop. It was in the front right prop mount. And so I was a little worried about that. I got my macro lens out and I zoomed in on it, and I saw that it wasn't mounted flush. It was tilted a little bit. And so I was like, crap, did I totally ruin, you know, my prop mounts on my Mini 2? And so what I did is I just got out one of the new screws and I replaced it with that screw, and it worked. It went in flush, it went in hard, but it did go in and it worked. And so the lesson here is don't use the Mavic Mini props on the Mini 2. Although it will fly, the screws are different and you're gonna retool the mounts on your Mini 2. And if you do it too often, it's probably gonna ruin it and you won't be able to install your props on there anymore. So that was the takeaway from that experience. So hopefully that helps you guys out. If you are thinking about trying that, don't try it. I don't recommend it at all. Just get, if you need props, just order some more props for the Mini 2, the actual Mini 2 props from DJI. Now, the last thing and the most common question that I got was, are the batteries interchangeable? Like, does the Mini 2 battery work in the Mavic Mini, and does the Mavic Mini battery work in the Mini 2? And one of them, yes, the Mavic Mini battery, the original, the black one, does work in the Mini 2. It flies normally. What I'm gonna do today is I'm going to do a flight test. I'm gonna check the speed difference, see if we have, you know, any reduction in speed because the voltage is different on the on those batteries. And then I'm gonna see if the flight time is any different. And then the other question was, can you use the Mini 2 battery in the Mavic Mini? And the answer is no, it doesn't fit. The insert is different, it's shaped different. So you can't go backwards, but you can go forwards. The Mavic Mini battery can work in the Mini 2. So I'm gonna do that right now. I'm gonna get the Mini 2 up in the air. First, to get a control, I'm gonna fly with the normal battery, the Mini 2 battery, and then I'm gonna put the Mavic Mini battery and do that. I'm just gonna fly around normally. I'll fly around a little bit, just random. It's not very pretty out today. Everything's brown and dead, and it's fall and it's gloomy. It's a great day for smoking ribs though. Got the Traeger running today. I love this time of year for smoking. But so I'm gonna get it flied around normally, and we'll check those two things, and then you guys can see. Oh, one more thing, I forgot to say this. This is actually a sixth question. Are the controllers interchangeable, like the Mavic Air 2 controller and the Mini 2 controller? Yes, they are. You can use either controller for either drone. You just have to pair them. And so when you bring up the Fly app, it'll ask you, do you want to connect the Mini 2 or do you want to connect to the Mavic Air 2? And you just choose it, and then you have to hold down the power button for 4 minutes on the drone and click on pair, and then they will automatically pair. It's pretty cool. And I think it's the future. I think DJI is going to eventually sell drones without the controller. So if you buy a Mini 2 now, a year from now, they release a new drone with that same controller design, you're gonna save a little bit of money because you won't have to buy that controller. So I think that's the future. I think it's coming, and I like it. I do. I like having that option. You can either buy the whole package or you can just buy the drone. So I think we're gonna see that. So let's get the Mini 2 up in the air and check the battery differences. All right, we have the Mini 2 battery, the proper battery. We're at 99%. And let's go ahead and fly. Okay, so we're getting to 20%. So now the low battery warning is coming on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring it back down and I'm just gonna let it hover until it lands by itself. We're gonna try to get it as low as we can. Actually, I'm not even gonna do that. I'm gonna let it come down and try to land by itself, but I'm gonna keep it up, and I'm gonna keep the drone hovering as long as I can, and until it just drops down. All right, there we go. We brought it down to 1%. Don't do that on a regular basis. That is not good for your batteries. All right, let's take a look at the flight time. The battery temp got up to 36.4 Celsius. And there's our flight time, 23 minutes and 39 seconds. It is just below freezing right now. It is 31 degrees Fahrenheit. Pretty cold. That's why I lost signal a couple times. You might notice on there, I had to go inside and find my gloves because my hands were freezing. So don't fly from inside the house. But so 2339, that's still pretty low. I'm still running, that means I'm still running 73% of maximum advertised flight time. I kept it between 150 feet and 250 feet. I went up and down, flew it all around. So a variety of different things. I didn't do any recording. But a little disappointing, 23 minutes, and this battery's been used 5 times, so it should be broken in by now. So anyway, let's get the Mavic Mini battery and put that in and see how that does compared to this one.
The home point has been updated. Please check it on the map.
One thing to remember, if you use the Mavic Mini battery in the Mini 2, it does put the Mini 2 above 250 grams. And so if you're flying like this, technically this should be registered with the FAA. Now, if you're only going to do it once in a while, you're probably going to be okay. But if you're going to use this battery on a regular basis, and if you happen to crash, someone finds it, turns it into the FAA and it's not registered and they find out it's you, you might get in trouble. So just keep that in mind. All right, let's fly. All right, so now we're getting the low battery voltage warning.
Battery level is low. The aircraft will go to the home point in 10 seconds.
Aircraft will return to home after countdown. So let's just get it closer to home. Coming up on 20%, and then I'll just bring it back to the same spot and let it hover till 1%. All right, so there we go. Let's check the flight time there. Boy, that battery really dropped fast. After I got that low voltage warning, it went down pretty fast. So let's check it out here. So our flight time for that flight was 22 minutes and 2 seconds. So about a minute and a half less than the Mini 2 battery. And about halfway through, I think it was running about the same as far as flight time, but as soon as it got to that low voltage, then it really started to drop. And so, yeah, so not quite as much time. The battery did not get as warm. Let's go back here and see. It's probably too late now. It's probably cooled off already, but let's just check it. So, well, it's at 31.2, so pretty close as far as the battery temperature, but the battery voltage at the end was 6.69. Now, this battery's been charged 12 times, where the Mini 2 battery was charged 5 times. Okay, so a little bit less flight time, heavier, still works. It works fine, flies normally. Speeds were the same. I think I got up to 34 in sport mode here and about 22 normal mode, so no reduction in speed. Just a little less flight time. Of course, the conditions aren't great today. There's no wind, but it's 30, 31 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's pretty chilly today. Definitely would be getting more flight time in warmer weather, but I'm still a little bit disappointed in that flight time. All right, so let's wrap this up. Smart controller report probably coming soon. My opinion, only my opinion. Same thing with goggle support. Do not use the Mavic Mini propellers on your Mini 2. They do work, but the screws are different and you're gonna wreck your mounts. You're gonna retool your mounts and eventually you're gonna have trouble. So don't do that. It's not worth it, not worth the trouble. You can't use the Mini 2 props on the Mavic Mini because they won't fit. Both controllers work. The Mavic Air 2 controller will control either drone, and the Mini 2 controller will control either drone, the Mini 2 or the Mavic Air 2. So that's very cool. And then finally, the battery works, but little less flight time, at least in these conditions. So hopefully I gave you something of value today. If I did, click on the thumbs up, subscribe if you're not, and follow me on social media, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter. Love to see you over there. I do some extra stuff there as well. Have a great day, everyone. Thank you for watching. And as always, fly safe and fly smart.